Hello friends, my name is M. Singh and I have completed MA History and MA Sociology and qualified UGC NET JRF with subject history. Today I am going to discuss about the sources of ancient Indian history. Sources of ancient Indian history is very important topic of ancient Indian history, because sources, without sources it is very difficult to write the history. In history, sources are very important to reconstruct the history of any particular period. So this topic, sources of Indian history, is very important. From this topic, different examinations, just like UGC and UPSC and state service examination and one day examination, a lot of question is asked in the examination. As well as this topic is very important for the person who want to pursue in the career in the research, because this sources told how to reconstruct the history. So that's why today I'm going to discuss this topic, ancient Indian history. Now what is the objective? If you talk about the objective of this thing, I want to discuss the first, the student make aware about the literary sources. Literary sources are important. The second thing, that is archaeological sources. The student will aware about the archaeological sources. Third thing, that is foreign account. Third thing, the student will aware about the foreign accounts. Means these three type of the ancient Indian sources today I will discuss. Now what is the introduction? If you talk about the introduction, then we discuss the first, for writing the history of ancient Indian, sources are important. Without sources it is very difficult to write the history. So this entire process for searching the sources, for interpreting the sources, the first time that was started by the British. Means this sources, the process of sources was first time started by the British, and the British administrative officers. That is why for this purpose 1784 the name, that is Sir William Jones established Asiatic Society of Bengal. The main purpose of Asiatic Society of Bengal, learning, understanding and publishing sources of ancient Indian history. Whatever the sources that was earlier existed, how to interpret those sources, how to publish those sources so that they can benefit by those sources, what was happened in the ancient India. Now second thing, in the field of archaeological sources, the first thing, archaeological sources, 1861, the British East India Company established archaeological department. Archaeological department, that is a department by which they start analyzing the archaeological sources, they start excavating the archaeological sources so that they can produce very good complementary of literary sources. Now third thing is this, ki what type the sources there. Now first thing, the sources are divided in three parts. The first, that is literary sources, second, that is archaeological sources, fourth, that is foreign account and traveler. All these three sources are very important for reconstructing the history. If any person, any student who want to write the history of ancient India, so they have to go through literary sources, they have to go through archaeological sources, they have to go through foreign account, and all the sources that is complementary each other. If any researcher who want to do the research in any topic in ancient India, they first have to literary sources, then he continue on archaeological sources, then he confirm the foreign account, then he decide to write the history. So this topic is very important for the researcher's purpose. This topic important for exam is one thing. The second thing is also important for the researcher's purpose. Now we start first the literary sources. What are literary sources we have? Now this is the first part. What are literary sources we have? First we started Literary sources of ancient Indian history again divided three parts: religious, secular, and scientific. Now, first thing means literary sources, that is also very important. And in this process, first, that is religious, first category, that is religious. In the religious category, it is very important the sources which is in nature of the religion. Like Vedas, Buddhist, Jain, these religion. The sources related to these religions. Now, second, that is secular. Now, in spite of religion, besides the religion, the some literature which is written by other scholars, that is called secular. In the secular, this is also very important sources. Now, third thing is this: some literary sources that was not comes in the category of the religion and secular, that is totally scientific. They will be, these type of sources give the scientific information regarding the ancient India. So the first literary sources divided three parts. So first I am going to discuss about the religious source. What the religious sources are? Now, religious sources divided three parts: Hindu religion, then Buddhist religion, then Jain religion. Means the literature related to the Hindu, Buddhist, and Jainism. So Hindu Vedic literature come in Hindu literature, that comes Vedas, Brahman, Aranyak, Upanishad, six philosophies, Smriti, and Puran. This comes in the Hindu literature or Vedic literature. Now, Buddhist literature, the some books that are related to the Buddhist literature and some book that are related to the Jain literature. So first I am going to discuss about the Vedic literature, what comes in the Hindu literature. Now, first topic, that is Vedas. Vedas. If you talk about Veda, the word comes from Vid. Vid means to know. Means Gyan. Now, second thing, it is basically compilation of prayers. Means this is not written by anyone. It was only compiled of Aryans, and whatever the prayer they have given towards the God, that is compiled here. So this is basically compilation of the Vedas, compilation. It is also called Sanghita. Vedas are four type: Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, and Athar Veda. So now, what the Rig Vedas? Rig Vedas, the first important thing is Rig Vedas, this earliest Vedas among all. Means this is very oldest Vedas. And in this Vedas, that is 10th mandal means chapter. 10th chapter and 1028 sukta. Sukta means poems, hymns. And whatever the prayer that is given here, that is dedicated to Indra, the god, Varun, Agni, Prajapan, Vayu, and Marut. On these gods, all the hymns that is dedicated. Besides this, this Veda also gave the information socio-economic condition, religious condition, political condition of early Aryans. Now, this is also given. This is also important thing of the Rig Veda that is given. Now, second thing that is very important for the caste system, 10th mandal, that is added Purush Sukt. In Rig Veda, the 10th mandal, new thing that is added in 10th mandal, that is called Purush Sukt. In this Purush Sukt, the information of Varna system that is given. And this is very important. Because why it is important? Because the entire caste system of Hinduism, that is comes from there. Because this in 10th Sukt, 10th Mandal, in 10th Mandal it is given that how the different caste that was immersed in Hinduism by the God. This is also given in Rig Vedas. Now, second thing, that is next Ved, that is Samved. Samved, that is another Ved, and the thing is this, in the Samved, the basically the information that is given how to recite the prayer, means how to recite the prayers, means how to recite the prayer during the pray to God. This process that is given here, as well as this is also called Indian, origin of Indian classical music. And most, this is made from the, means most of the hymns that is also given here. So this is the feature of the Somved, Samved. Now third one, that is Yajurved. Yajurved, and prayer to recite while performing the sacrifices, means whatever the sacrifices perform, that is prayer, means the sacrifices prayer that is given here. Here that is Samved, that is how to recite, this is process given how to recite the prayer, but here that is given prayer, name of the prayer that is given, whatever the perform towards the God. Now second thing, this is also made major part of this Yajurveda, taken from the Rigveda itself. So it's Rigveda itself, and it has two part, the Shukla Yajurveda and Krishna Yajurveda. This is two part that is also part of the Rigveda Yajurveda. Now third thing, this Atharved, fourth, that is called Atharved. Athar was very important. Atharved was very important because here it is given magic, black magic, and superstition. A lot of thing, lot of information that is given here. Magic, black magic, superstition also. Besides this, medicine, botany, and surgery. This is also very authentic book of ancient Indian history. Now another important thing which is related to this, that is called Vedic related, is called Brahmana. Brahmana, that is another thing which is related to the Hindu literature. The Vedas, the basic Brahman is to make Vedas more understandable, it is created. The main thing is this, Brahman's main purpose to give knowledge to the people so that they can understand Vedas very easily. It is also the procedure of the sacrifices, it is also in this, it is also content procedure of the sacrifices. Provide the information, different RN institutions such as Varna, Four Ashram. This is also a specific thing which is contained in the Brahmans also. Brahman have, each and every Vedas have the Brahman. Rigveda have Atre Brahman. Atre Brahman is a Rigveda. Samved, Jaimini Brahman, that is Samved. Yajurved, Satpat Brahman. And Atharved, Gopal Brahman. Most of the question, lot of questions is asked from this line itself. Rigveda Atre Brahman, Samved Jaimini Brahman, Yajurved Satpat Brahman, and Atharved Jaimini Brahman. And basically the question that is match the word. This type of question were asked from this line. Now second thing, Upanishad, that is another point, that is Upanishad, that is another literature of the Vedic period. The means to learn by sitting near to the teacher, means the person who are sitting near to teacher to learn, that is called Upanishad. Upanishad means in any students, any disciples who are sitting near teacher to learn about the Vedas, that is called Upanishad. This is basically learning of Vedic speech, means whatever the all the sacrifices that is given in the Vedas, but this is Upanishad, this is the spiritualism of the Vedic system. Besides this, knowledge of oneself, what was the purpose of the persons in this earth, knowledge of God, relation between self and God, creation of universe, it also known as a Vedanta, means these are other feature which is related to the Upanishad, and this is also very important for examination point of view. A lot of question is asked from here. Now another thing, that is Vedang. Now besides Brahman, Upanishad, one more important thing comes in the very little, that is called Vedang. Vedang, the meaning of Vedang is this, to learn the Vedas very easily, more understandable. That's why Vedang were created. Vedang, sixth of Vedang is there, first, that is Siksha. With the help of this, how to pronounce the Vedic prayer, means this is the proper, in the proper manner, this situation is given the Vedanga, how to pronounce the Vedic prayer in the proper manner, this is given. Now kalp, Second thing, that is scalp, rule to perform the sacrifice in the problem, means the rules ki how the sacrifices perform. This rule is given. How to pronunciate, first thing, how to recite, that is given the siksha. The kalp, that is how to perform the sacrifices, which is given here, there. This kalp is three type. First, that is swastha shastra based on shruti, teach, perform the great sacrifices. This taught how the sacrifices were performed at that time. Now, grahasutra, that is domestic rule, that is given, and the dharmasutra, that is customs and social duties of the particular person, that is given here in Vedanga. Now, another thing, that is vyakaran. This is written, this is proper grammar, that is proper grammar. Each and every Sanskrit, because Vedas written in Sanskrit, each and every Sanskrit term, that is given a proper meaning by the vyakaran. Now, nirukt, that is etymology of the word mentioned in the Vedas, it is given there. Now, chand, that is another thing, that is Vedic sloka or structure to recite it. Gayatri mantra like this, chand, and anusrava meter, that is also chand. Our chand, that is another important thing here, it is given slokas. Now, another thing, another important thing, that is jyotish, it deals with the proper times, sakun, apsakun, sacrifices performed, moon, sun, and constellations, activities, cycles of season, these things, that is given in the jyotish. So, these are very important part. Vedanga also very important point, and a lot of questions also ask from this topic. This is very important. Now, another important thing, that is Sat Darshan, means six philosophies of India. All the Indian philosophy, that is based on this thing. So here the question basically not asked in the deep, the question basically asked in very superficial, means the particular darshan and their founder. Now, Vaisheshik, Kanad, Nyay, Kanad, Sank, Kapil, Yog, Patanjali, Mimamsa, Jaimini, Uttar Mimamsa, Badrayan. So these are the some important Sat Darshan is here. In detail study, detail of the Sat Darshan, we will discuss next other slides. Now, what the Smriti? Another important thing, that is Smriti. Smriti, that was also very important, because Smriti's main function, the main theme of the Smriti is the social and political rules and regulation is given. Social political rules and regulation is given here. Now, that is first century, the second century, norms, code, rules, regulation, and consolidate, reconstruct the Vedic religion, it is given and written by Manu, Narad, Parasar, and Yagvalak. These are the some Smriti which is very important for literary point of view, because for reconstructing the ancient Indian history. Now, another thing, that is Puran, that is very important. Another important thing, Puran, that is another important thing which is given here. 18 Puran is there in India. 18 Puran is there. Main subject of Puran, universe, origin of universe, story regarding respective God and his family, it is given there. It is also important, pilgrimage center, pilgrimage, political dynasty, medicine, geography. These are the subject which is given in the Puran. With the help of the Puran, anybody can get the information of the particular things for writing, for reconstructing the history. Now, another important thing, that is comes in this category. So, these are the Vedic literature we have told. So, thank you for watching my channel. And if you think ki my channel is making good for you, so you like my channel, subscribe my channel, and share and give the comment on my channel. If you think I will try to give the answer of your comment. Thank you very much.